Today we are going to see a very interesting thing. 13 witnesses to all our activities. There are 13 witnesses who are observing all our activities and actions. This is mentioned in Srimad Bhagavatam, 6th canto, 1st chapter, text number 42. So, Srimad Bhagavatam is giving the information of these 13 witnesses. The shloka of the Srimad Bhagavatam is as follows. Suryo Agni Kham Marut Deva Soma Sandhyayani Disha Kam Kuh Swayam Dharma Iti Hi Ete Deihasya Shakshina. We are being observed by the superior authorities who are working under the Supreme Lord Shri Krishna. All our records are kept. The Yamaraj, who is the superintendent of death, and his secretary Chitragupta, they have all the records of all the living entities in this world. And they are keeping these records by collecting them from these 13 witnesses. We will shortly see which are these 13 witnesses. So, we cannot escape from the higher authorities. All our actions are getting noticed. The superintendent of death, Yamaraj, has every information. Chitragupta, his secretary, has such a supercomputer that we cannot imagine. In that supercomputer, all the records of all the living entities are kept. And according to the actions, the results are given. This is the arrangement of the law of karma, which is working under the supervision of the Supreme Lord, Sri Krishna. So, now we will see what are these 13 witnesses. So, these 13 witnesses are fire, sun, sky, moon, evening, night, day, directions, water, air, land, demigods, and ultimately super soul. So, one may say that how can moon observe my activities? How can sky observe my activities? How can day, night, directions observe one's activities? Actually, in the Vedic literature, everything has a personality behind it. The moon has a personality behind it. The sky has a personality behind it. The sun has a personality behind it. Surya Dev, Vivashwan is the Surya Dev. Fire has a personality behind it. Agni Dev, demigods, the devatas like Indra, Varun, water has a personality behind it. So these personalities, these are not just things, there are personalities behind it. So they are observing the activities of the living entities. And we cannot escape. We might somehow or the other escape the observation of the government, but we cannot escape the observation of the Supreme Government, of the Supreme Lord. So, ultimately, these 13 witnesses are observing all our actions. So, the most important of these 13 witnesses is the Super Soul. Super Soul is actually Supreme Lord Shri Krishna Himself. So, if the other 12 observers, the other 12 personalities somehow misses us, somehow cannot observe one of our activities, then ultimately Super Soul will definitely observe it. Because Super Soul is the Supreme Lord Himself. We cannot escape from the eyes of the Super Soul, the Supreme Lord. So, this is the arrangement of the Supreme Lord. These 13 witnesses, if 12 of them misses out, then the 13th witness, Super Soul, will definitely not miss anything. The Super Soul is situated in the heart region of every living entity. He is observing everything. He is Supreme Lord Shri Krishna. And when we turn towards the Super Soul, when the soul turns towards the Super Soul, then it becomes happy. And that is the goal of human form of life, to turn our attention back towards the Supreme Soul, Super Soul, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Shri Krishna. That can be done very easily by chanting the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. So let us turn ourselves back towards the Supreme Lord, the Super Soul, then our life will be successful. Hare Krishna. So if you like these knowledge from the Vedic scriptures, which are revolutionary in themselves, from Srimad Bhagavatam, which are revolutionary in themselves, so then please subscribe to the channel and click the bell icon and share these videos. Hare Krishna.